All right, thanks, Greg. We'll see you later. This year's midterm election means a rematch in one state Senate district. That was a close one last time. In the 46th district, a new survey suggests one candidate has a comfortable lead, but no one's resting with polls opening in less than 48 hours. Lynn Falsetti takes a look at what the latest numbers might mean for each candidate.
Time is ticking for Senate candidates George Amador and Cecilia Kacik to secure voters ahead of Tuesday's election. The race for the 46th Senate district will determine which party controls the New York State Senate. And according to a Siena research poll released Sunday morning, voters are leaning more towards Republican George Amador. He's ahead with 54% of likely voters, a two-digit lead over Kacik with 43%.
What's interesting here is that not much has changed at all in the 4 weeks since the first Siena poll. In the first Siena poll, Amador had a 10-point lead over Kacik. Today, he has an 11-point lead over Kacik.
A much different story than the first time the two candidates ran against each other, Kacik winning by just 18 votes. Each candidate has slammed the other, accusing them of being supported by New York City's special interests, and both of them spending more than $5 million on the campaign. According to the poll, however, more voters feel Kacik is running the most negative ads.
Mostly the ads have been negative ads, attacking George Amador, attacking Celia Kacik. Well, apparently the ads attacking Amador just really haven't worked, because right now Amador still has a very good favorability rating.
Amador and Kacik are speaking out on the findings. Kacik was not in the Capital Region Sunday, but her campaign spokesman issued to us this statement saying, quote, "Our campaign team has knocked on 100,000 doors and made more than 130,000 phone calls. The voters we've spoken with know that George Amador has been bought and paid for by the anti-choice right wing and corporate special interests supporting his candidacy. On election day, we are going to pull out our vote and win this race."
Right now, we have a senator who has represented New York City's special interest 97% of the time. And, you know, I'm fighting hard to stand in the gap and to represent the residents of upstate New York.
Meanwhile, her opponent, George Amador, was hard at work securing votes in the district. He says in response to the findings, the race isn't over.
"The only poll that matters most to me is the poll on election day, Tuesday."
Stephen Greenberg, pollster with the Siena Research Institute, says Kacik has an uphill battle, especially in this district.
"This is one of the only districts we've seen where Andrew Cuomo is not beating Rob Astorino. And in fact, Astorino has an 8-point lead over Andrew Cuomo in this district, even though this district has slightly more Democrats than Republicans. So that makes Kacik's challenge that much harder. In these closing days of the election, what the Kacik camp has to do is find a way to bring those Democrats back home into supporting her and to cut into Amador's lead with those independent voters."
In Gilderland, Lynn Falsetti, CBS 6 News.